Hello everyone. Welcome to the lecture series on renewable energy engineering. I am Nili Trivedi, Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department at LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. We are studying the wind energy chapter, which is really very important chapter for us. Now in this session, we will study about the classification of wind turbine and so more. Okay, so let us start. Now, let us study about the component of wind turbine. It has total 5 components like windmill head, then wind turbine or rotor, then generator and supporting structure and transmission and control, as you see in this diagram. Now first of all, we have to understand what is windmill head. Okay, so it gives the mechanical support to the rotor basically, and housing of the rotor is known as windmill head, okay, in which all the system are mounted basically. Now what is the turbine or a rotor? So the whatever the object which is rotating in the wind mill, it is known as the rotor. Okay, with the blade and the center part, the whole system is known as rotor. Generally, this rotor is the only component which convert the kinetic energy of the wind into the mechanical and to the electrical energy. Okay, there are basically two types of rotor, known as horizontal axis rotor and vertical axis rotor. Now, third one, the part known as a generator. Generally, electrical generator produces the electrical energy when it is rotated by the wind turbine. Generally, just like that. It means generator converts mechanical energy into the electrical one, simply. Now, supporting structure. It is very important because there are the complete load of the windmill. Rotating as well as standing, both are only on the supporting structure. Okay, now there are different type of supporting structure like a tower or a tabular steel or a frame like a structure, many more. Now transmission and control, this is also the very important equipment of this. So transmission and control, so part A, as you see in this diagram, indicates the transmission. It means speed increaser and driving shaft, clutch and coupling. So this is the transmission and control. Now let us have the classification of windmill. As you see, there are number of different types of windmills. So here, according to the position of the shaft axis. Now according to the position of a shaft axis, it has two types, horizontal and vertical. Now again in the horizontal there are 6 types and vertical there are 2. We will see it later on. Now second one is according to the wind direction of the rotor. It means upwind rotor and downwind rotor. Okay, so we have to study this. Now according to the number of blades, it means single, double, triple or multi. Okay, now then according to the design of rotor blades. Now design of rotor blades are really very important. First one is a propeller type, single or multi blade. Then sail type, it means in the sail type you may use the cloth material. And a Dutch type. So there are 3 types according to the design of the blade and according to the application, water pumping, irrigation or power generation. So here there are multiple types of windmills available. Now let us have the types of wind machine. It means basically the type of wind machine, horizontal axis and vertical axis. Basically we have to divide it in these 2 groups. So in the horizontal wind axis wind machine, there are 6 types: propeller type, multi blade type, sail type, Dutch type, Magnus type, fan type. So there are 6 types. And in a vertical type of wind machine, it is Savonius and Darius. Okay, so Savonius and Darius, they both are the different types. So now let us have, as you see in this diagram, it is a propeller type windmill. So this type of windmill are used where there is a very low wind flow. Okay, it required to rotate the rotor at a certain high speed. So propeller type of windmill generally used if the wind flow at a very low rate. Okay, it contains aerodynamic design. Generally, aerodynamic design will increase the speed of this particular component, and made of a plastic fiber and any of the lighter material, because if we use the heavier material, it will reduce its speed also due to the weight. Now it is made of a very thin section so that it rotates at a higher speed. Now if we see the advantages, generally if we understand it, it will rotate at 300 to 400 RPM and can generate the electricity very well. Now at a household purpose or inside the city area, we can use this kind of windmill. Now it is simple in a blade control, and it also uses for a low wind speed. Now the main disadvantage of this system is vibrations are very much produced. And as we have already studied about the vibration, it will cause a lot of suffer to the equipment. So this is the propeller type of windmill. Okay. So if it is asking your examination, you have to draw the diagram properly. And if you see, it is very simple. Now, let us have multi-blade type windmill. So in the design, this is multi-blade. It means there are uncountable blades, or if we can count, it is more than three. Okay, more than three are considered as multi-blade turbine. So for carrying this, we have to use the two rings. As you see, there is one at the inner side and one at the outer side. The RPM is around 60 to 80 RPM, and the efficiency of the system is around 20 to 25%. Now what are the advantages? Generally, because it is using multi blades, it should use some rigid structure, and which is having very less speed, because the mass of this structure will rise. So let us have the advantages and disadvantages. It has a good power coefficient. This power is generated more easily, and high starting torque is generated, and better reliability. One or two blades may fail, then we can also use the system. Now disadvantages: rotor speed is very less. Okay, working efficiency is low, and it is not used for power generation, which is the most main disadvantage of it. Generally, it is used for water pumping system. As you see, in so many offshore areas, it is used for water pumping system. So the diagram, as you see, it is very simple. You can use it. Now let us study about sail type windmill. Okay, so as you see, the sail type windmill, it means it may have some cloth type material attached to it. The blade surface made from the wooden strips or iron strips covered by the nylon or polyester cloth. Okay, just like the sailor sails the boat, and what happens when the boat sails, the cloth material, which is made of the polyester or nylon one, will move the boat towards the outside. Now it is just the system where we use the sailing type of this. Now the rotation is nearly 60 to 80 RPM. Nearly this kind of windmill used for various application like water pumping and electric power generation. It means it can use in both of the purpose. Now what are the advantages? Now it is simple and light in the construction, because we use the wooden sticks, and easy to install and maintain. But and what are the applications? So it is used for water pumping as well as electrical power generation, as we have already discussed. But what I think the main disadvantage is, if there is because we are using the polymer and nylon material, the stability or the reliability will be lesser as compared to any other grades. Right, now let us study about Dutch type windmill. Okay, now this type of windmill, as you see in this diagram, it is one of the oldest design. Okay, just we were using it for in a flour mill for grinding the grains. Okay, so there are four numbers of plates as you count on it, are opposite to each other, exactly opposite, and made of wood. It is having just a frame like structure and tower made from the brick. Okay, and there are two rotating bearings used on the top of the tower. Okay, one can rotate the rotor and pulley is fitted to the shaft and rotate the machine by the belt. Now this windmill mainly used for water pumping, grinding, etc. Okay, so this is Dutch type windmill. Now Magnus windmill, as you see, it has the special type of design, Magnus. And this turbine uses the barrel or a half cut cylinder instead of blades. So we need to use the barrels, like different types of designs are available. Now this barrel revolves around its own axis. Now right now there are lots more practical based on this system. Now Magnus effect is produced and due to this rotor because it rotates on its axis, its periphery. Now this type of windmill is also suitable for high speed wind. Okay, and the application is used for the, it is only used for the electrical power generation. Now let us have the fan type windmill. Its name indicates that it is a fan blade. The fan blades are used in this system. Okay, the blades made from iron strip covered with canvas cloth, and the rotor is big and contain two to three or more than that blades. Now what is the application? It will generally used for the power water pumping system. Okay, now next one, it is a Savonius rotor type windmill. It was used nowadays. It is a vertical axis wind turbine. Okay, generally the scientist named S.J. Savonius has invented this type of Savonius windmill. Now it has become popular because it requires relatively low velocity wind for operation. So at a low velocity you can also produce the power, and which is the most important cause of using this. Now windmill rotate up to in the S shaped two half cylinder facing the opposite direction. Okay, just like in the playground we have this kind of equipments. So wind from any direction can enter in the bucket and bounce back after imparting an impulse effect. Okay, what are the advantages? So this type of windmill is suitable at a low speed, and low wind can also produce the power. The starting is very easy, the design is very simple and easy to manufacture as well as easy in maintenance. Overall weight of the turbine is very less, it can be used at a lesser height also. Okay, the cost of the vertical axis wind turbine is lower than the standard wind turbine, and in this type of windmills nowadays they are using it on the highway roads. Okay, now what are the disadvantages? This type of machine is basically bulky one, okay, heavy one, and the length of the driving shaft is very high and supports are needed. It is not useful for very tall installation. The working efficiency is also very low and rotor size is very big. Now what are the applications? So it is suitable for water pumping and agricultural work. Nearly the efficiency is about 15%. Now Darius rotor type windmill. If you see this, it is invented by the French engineer G.J.M. Darius. Okay, now this type of windmills are already used in Canada. Now it has two or three symmetrical airfoil blades which are mounted on a vertical axis shaft. This shaft is supported by bearings at the top and the bottom. Now vertical shaft is connected to the generator. Now main advantage is that this type of rotor blade is that it can accept the wind from any of the direction. Okay, so if there is a wind in any of the direction, it will rotate. Now what are the advantages? The working efficiency is high, nearly 35 to 40% is, and wind will rotate with a very high speed. So it is suitable for power generation. Now no separate transmission are required. It can be used in a low speed wind also. and the design of a blade and rotor are very, very similar. Now, what are the disadvantages? They are not self-starting. It needs auxiliary starter. Its starting torque is very less, so it is not suitable for water pumping. Now, power output is less when compared to the other conventional windmill, and there is no yaw control, okay, and working efficiency is also less, clear? So, lower than the horizontal. Horizontal rotor is having a very good working efficiency, but the working efficiency is low in this case if we compare it with horizontal axis. Okay, so this is for today. Thank you all of you for watching this video. If you have any query, you can contact me. Thank you.